Hi everybody, this is your course introductory video for History 111, World History up to 1500. I am your instructor and my name is Crystal Moore. You are welcome to call me Crystal if you like. I'm a history instructor here at Central Piedmont Community College in the Behavioral and Social Sciences Department. I've been teaching here for about a year and a half, and before that I taught at Wingate University, UNC Charlotte, and UNC Chapel Hill. I enjoy teaching a variety of courses, but my specialty is really the history of sexuality and gender in colonial and early America. And in particular, I'm what you would call a social historian. I know a lot of you have probably taken history classes in the past in high school where you learn sort of what I call the old dead white guy history. You learn a lot about the founding fathers of our country and big businessmen and major wars and events in history. But what I like to do as a social historian is look at the average men and women who built a particular country and see what they were doing in a particular time period. I like to make sure that history is not whitewashed, to ensure that we talk about women, that we talk about people of color, that we talk about people who were poor. And it means that it's a different kind of history, that we're not necessarily focusing on the meta history or the big picture, but instead we're focusing on the small little day-to-day events that end up creating a different kind of history than what you might be used to studying. But it's history that is still essential to understand how people lived in the past, the way people believed, and how both of those influenced the way that we run our society today. So in this course, you're going to get a mixture of social history and sort of the traditional history that you guys are used to. We will start by talking about the first humans, and we will go through the first wave civilizations of ancient Egypt and Mesopotamia, China, the Indus River Valley, Norte Chico, and the Olmec. And then we'll go through the second wave civilizations with ancient Rome and Greece and Persia and Macedonia, and several of the civilizations that you've probably learned a great deal about in history classes or from blockbuster movies. And then we will move through the Middle Ages. We'll talk about the Byzantine Empire, Western Europe, the Islamic world, and China in the Middle Ages. And finally, we will end with really the beginning of the Age of Exploration. We'll go through the Renaissance and the Scientific Revolution and see how we begin the transition from ancient history to modern history. And there's really a lot of interesting stuff that we're going to cover in the course. Part of what I think will make it so interesting is that we're going to try every week to give you all some questions that allow you to connect the past with the present. And I want to do this so that you understand current events and what the historical basis for these events are, but also so that you can further develop your opinions about different goings-on in society and politics and the economic system of the world today. So I wanted to just quickly introduce myself and tell you a little bit about me as well. I, in the past, have worked as a rape crisis counselor, and I still devote some of my time to doing that. When I have free time, I spend most of it with my husband, and this is my husband right here. This is Robbie. He's wearing a Ravens jersey because he is a diehard Ravens fan. The rest of my free time I spend with my dog. This is Winston Peabody. He is a mix of a Dogo Argentino, which is a Mastiff from Argentina, and a Pitbull. And he is deaf, so he knows sign language. Of course, he doesn't sign back, but he obeys the sign language when he feels like it. You might occasionally hear him barking when I'm making videos, or you might see him prancing behind me doing his little pony dance sometimes. You may also see one of my two cats. We've got Henry VIII and also Gracie May, and they enjoy coming into the study and seeing what's going on as well. I'm very involved in animal advocacy, especially through a group in Charlotte known as the Coalition to Unchain Dogs, and we go around and build fences, particularly for families that own pit bulls that are chained up outside. And then I'm also involved with social justice pursuits, pursuits to find equality in class, race, and gender status, both in North Carolina and in the country and around the world. So that's a little bit about me. I hope that I'm going to get to know a bit about you all through your first discussion board post, which should be interesting to read. But I also hope that you will take some time if you just want to come say hi and visit me in my office, or if you ever have questions that you'll feel comfortable to come and speak with me. My office is on the Levine campus, which is in Matthews. It's room 2440. It is now well decorated and it smells good and has candy for visitors, so hopefully that will entice someone to come visit. So far, we're 4 weeks into the semester and I haven't had any student visitors yet, but I hope to break that pattern. And otherwise, I'm just really looking forward to getting to know all of you as we move throughout the semester and I start to read your work and kind of see what your perspective is of historical events and current events. So as far as getting started in the class, what you want to make sure that you do first is to log into the course Moodle site. We don't use Blackboard here. We use Moodle, and you can access it through moodle.cpcc.edu. And you log in with the same username and email that you would use. The same username and password that you would use for your email or that you would use for Blackboard. Once you get in there, this is probably the only class you have on Blackboard. Not many teachers use it. And so it's pretty self-explanatory. On the left-hand side, you'll see a tab that says My Courses, and you can hit the drop-down menu and select History 111 from there. There are two different sections that are sharing this particular course. There's going to be Section 65 and Section 85. So when you go in and you look under the course documents, you want to make sure that you look at the schedule and the syllabus that's relevant for your particular section. After that, what you really want to do is read through that syllabus, make sure that you purchase the course textbook. It is Connections, A World History. It's a big old giant textbook, but it is helpful in some cases for review. And then the very first thing that the school mandates that you do is something called an enrollment verification activity. You only have to do these online, and you need to do them by the 10% date in the course, which is the 24th of September. And what you're going to do for my course to verify that you're enrolled and you've logged in and that you agree with the course settings and standards is that you're going to fill out a contract. And I've already typed up the contract and uploaded it to Moodle. And this contract says what I expect of you as a student, but it also lists all of the things that I guarantee you as an instructor, which you may find a little bit rare, but hopefully refreshing as well. And so what you will do is sign that contract and you will upload it to the link on Moodle before 11:55 p.m. on the 24th of September. If you do not do this, if you forget to do it, there is no way that you'll be allowed to stay in the class. The school will remove you, withdraw you from the class. I have no power over that, no matter how much I want to help you, I won't be able to. Once you finish the EVA, you're really going to start doing the coursework, and the way it will work is that each week I will upload some documents for you to read or videos for you to watch about a particular civilization or time period in history. You will have one quiz each week that goes along with it that's due by Sunday evening, and you will have a discussion board that's due by Sunday evening. The discussion board will be a mixture of opinion regarding what you've learned over the week, as well as kind of a connection to what's going on in the present world. It's a great way for you to get to know your classmates. It's a good way for me to get to know you. And it's a really good way for you to engage in critical thinking and applying the themes of the course to your life. So I think at this point, you probably have a pretty good idea of what the course is going to be about. You know how to get started on the course, but if you have any issues at all with using Moodle, the syllabus has several links on it to places where you can train, do online training for using Moodle. Also, you can contact the ITS Help Desk. Their phone number is 704-330-5000. Or you can always contact me. My contact information is available on the course website. It's probably best to get a hold of me via email. I check it several times a day. And that email is crystal.moore, M-O-O-R-E, at cpcc.edu. I look forward to getting to know all of you, and if you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to contact me.